welcome back to another week of Weekly Wisdom here with your boy Sean John. So I want to talk to you this week about breathing life. So we need to understand that we have the ability to inspire other people, but first and foremost we have to inspire ourselves and understand what it is that truly inspires us. Howard Thurman once said, you know, don't ask what the world needs. Instead, ask what makes you come alive. Because what the world needs more of is people who have come alive. I think that is such an important quote in the times that we're in right now, because people are literally dying right now because, not because of necessarily like COVID and racial injustice and everything, and I'm very sensitive to that and people who have lost folks, but because they are not going after the things that have made them come alive. We always talk about that this is gonna be new year, new me, and we've even made excuses right now of like, oh, I can't do this because I'm in quarantine. Trust me, you can make the plans to pursue the things that make you come alive. You can make the plans to pursue the things that make you come alive. Because at the end of the day, if you aren't going to pursue the things that make you come alive, then what are you actually going to be pursuing? Now understand, yes, there are some financial pieces and there are other things that come with it, but at the end of the day, that's where you can begin to make the plans. There's a quote out there that says, without a vision, the people will perish. And so you can even begin to make a vision for yourself, to even understand what it is that you have been called to do, what your destiny is right now in this world, and begin to look at the little things that you've been drawn to. So, for example, back in middle school, I remember going to tell my parents that I no longer wanted to wrestle, which was a crazy thing to think about at the time because I was one of the top wrestlers in the country. State titles, national titles, All-American recognition. But I just decided that that's no longer what was really making me come alive. Now, I liked it. You know, I really enjoyed it and I still enjoy it to this day. I watch the NCAA championships. You know, anytime I'm around people that talk about amateur wrestling and everything, I enjoy those conversations. But the things that really were making me come alive at that point, and even to this day, I realized were leadership development, mentoring, coaching, you know, helping people become better individuals. Because I did not want to see anybody fail anymore. Because failure is walking into a place where you don't feel like you even value yourself there. You know, no matter what it costs, you know, you can still value yourself there because you're going to have to make sacrifices and, you know, and do different things regardless. But if at the end of the day, you're in spots in life where you truly can't even look at yourself in the mirror anymore, then you might need to ask yourself the question, is that what making you come alive? Is that breathing life into you? And so there's no better time than the present. Yes, you have 6 months left in this year, but you still have a whole lifetime with today. So take moments today to pursue the things that make you come alive. I don't want to see anybody perish and leave this earth and not have pursued the dreams that they've had. Write them down, plan them out, pursue them, and watch the growth happen. Peace and blessings, everybody. That's another week of Weekly Wisdom. And so I'm your boy, Sean John. Follow me on Instagram at @TheSeanJohn_Sun. You can also subscribe to my YouTube page and get the updates when these videos get uploaded weekly. So once again, one love. See y'all.
I've walked among the shadows. You wipe my tears away.